Mohanty.
धन्यवाद.
Chairman sir, I Anubhav Mohanty from Biju Janata Dal rise to support this bill. The Indian Medical Council Amendment Bill 2019, introduced by the government, seeks to replace the Indian Medical Council Amendment second ordinance issued during the previous regime. This bill shall supersede the Indian Medical Council for a period of 2 years, sir. During the period of supersession, a Board of Governors, BOG, that is an alternative mechanism, shall be carrying out the functions of the Medical Council of India, that is to oversee the medical education and practice, and shall exercise all powers and functions of Medical Council of India under the Indian Medical Act 1956. This move shall ensure transparency, accountability, and quality in governance of medical education. The number of members in the BOG will be increased from the existing 7 to 12. Now, sir, the reason why this bill has been brought. The arbitrary action by the Medical Council of India is in disregard to provisions of the Indian Medical Council Act came to the notice of the Health Ministry. The Supreme Court appointed an overnight committee to oversee the functioning of the Medical Council of India. The Medical Council of India did not comply with the instructions of the Oversight Committee. This led to the resignations by all the members of the Oversight Committee. The government, under these circumstances, brought an ordinance and dissolved the Medical Council of India. This is how the functions of the Medical Council of India has been entrusted to the Board of Governors. Sir, these are the normal features of the bill. But, I have few questions and would request the Honorable Minister to clarify them, sir. Through you, I would like to put some questions to the Honorable Minister. My question number one is, sir, if there were provisions which were misused by the previous MCI, what precautions has the government taken to ensure the same thing will not be repeated again? My second question, sir, what are the new measures that the government is taking to ensure that the members of the MCI are kept under constant check and vigil? My third question, how is the government planning to strengthen the accountability of Medical Council of India? Fourth, sir, what action has the government initiated against those who grossly misuse their position and authorities as the members of Medical Council of India? My fifth question, sir. Sir, I have made my speech very comprehensive and very straightforward. I'm not going to speak much on this, but my questions are very, very important and very straightforward to the Honorable Minister. Through you, I would expect him to answer all the questions. So my fifth question, what is the reason to increase the number of members of the Board of Governors? What is the reason behind this? Seventh, sir, is the government planning to create space for their loyal retired bureaucrats in the board? If not, please clarify your stand for including bureaucrats. My eighth question, sir, will that not create a tussle between the doctors and the bureaucrats and hamper the functioning of the council? My ninth question, will such a move in any way curtail the autonomous character of the council? My 10th question, sir, after that only one question will be left. What steps is the government taking to ensure the spirit of the purpose in the larger interest is upheld? My last question, sir, how does the government propose to settle the grievances of the public against the wrong decisions of the Medical Council of India? Sir, while thanking you for the opportunity given to me to speak, I shall earnestly request Honorable Minister to kindly address my questions. And also, as I represent one of the wonderful constituencies of Odisha, which is Kendrapara, I would request Honorable Minister, sir, through the state government and from my side and from people of Kendrapara, I request you to kindly have a medical college there in Kendrapara. Why not each district in the country have a medical college, like Phulbani in Odisha, like in Barampur, anywhere, sir, because it will really help those patients, those who come, because people have to travel a long way, sir. We have wonderful medical colleges, but to travel, to communicate, to reach the place on time or at the right time is really difficult. I urge upon the government, I request the government, the minister here, he's himself here, I would expect an answer from him, sir. All support shall be provided you from the state government, and you shall not face any kind of hurdles or any kind of problems. I request you, please, sir, we are open. Please start a medical college for Kendrapara and other districts of Odisha. Thank you so much. Jai Jagannath, Bande Utkala Janani.
Dr. Sri Subhash Bhamre.